Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is G-transform. Here, let me explain why do we need G-transform, and let me compare G-transform and Laplace transform. Okay, then, how do we obtain the impulse response of systems? Now, input, impulse response and the output is x of n plus 0.2 y n minus 1. First, we can start concept of impulse response. Okay. Impulse response means originally h of n means output y of n instead of x of n, we substitute that of n, then we can get h of n. Therefore, from this, h of n equal x of n, instead of x of n, we can x of n, that of n, plus 0.2 h n minus 1. And here, h n minus 1 is also h n minus 1 means that of n minus 1 plus 0.2 h n minus 2. Also, n minus 2, also you can write h n minus 2 means that of n minus 2 plus 0.2 h n minus 3 like that. Then this goes to infinity. Then here, from here, h of n means, from here, that of n plus 0.2, h n minus means this one, therefore, that of n minus 1 plus 0.2, h n minus 2 is this one, then n minus 2 plus 0.2, something something here equal that of n plus 0.2 that of n minus 1 plus 0.2 therefore 0.2 square del n minus 2 plus like that. Okay, now this is the equation of the impulse response here. Also, we can represent the sequence. Means here 1, this means 0.2, this 0.2 square, 0.2 cubic goes to this, and here n equal 0. Like this, we can obtain the impulse response from concept of impulse response. And another way is from the G transform. Now from this, let me suppose G transform here. Of course, I will explain next slide. First, now, or let me suppose a G transform of this is, we can write like this, y over G equal x over G plus 0.2 G to the power minus 1, y over g. Okay. From this, y over g, 1 minus 0.2 g to the power minus 1 equals x of g. Here, y over g by x over g. We call this transfer function h over g equal 1 by 1 minus 0.2 g to the power minus 1. Here, we need some condition. Now, 0.2 g to the power minus 1, modulus is less than 0. Then here, now, next, what you have to do is, okay, from here, we need to inverse g transform. Then we can get h of n equal 0.2 to the power of n u over n like this. Now, also you can get the same result from the G transform and from the impulse the same on this one. But now you can see here, this method you can do, but this is some tedious. Okay, but now in this case, this is very simple and it's very easy. Therefore, we need G transform for obtaining the impulse response from the G transform. We can get impulse response. This way is better than this concept of impulse response. Next is how to know the frequency response of theta. Input, impulse response, and from this. How do we know this is impulse, the frequency response means H omega equal, how do we know that one? For that, also, we can use the G transform. From this, that before I said, we already H over G equal 1 by 1 minus 0.2 G to the power minus 1. Okay. Okay, now G means exponential J omega. Therefore, we can substitute this one instead of this. Therefore, H omega equal 1 by 1 minus 0.2 instead of G. This instead of G, we can use exponential minus J omega. Then this is a function of, this means function of omega. Omega means 0 to 2 pi. Okay. Therefore, from this we can get the amplitude spectrum and phase spectrum also from this. Okay. Like this, if we know this output, from this we can know the frequency response from the frequency response from the G, like this G transform. Actually, the transform is like this. Here, this is one of the low pass filter you can get. Okay. Next. Okay. Therefore, we need G transform. We want to know frequency response of the system. We can start from the G transform. That's why we need G transform. Next. Sometimes we can see the many kind of this kind of equations in some papers. Then what does this mean? Just before I explained, this means frequency response. It means H over G. Therefore, H over G is 1 minus 0.75 G to the power minus 1. That means H, G, instead of G, we can use substitute J omega. Then from this, 1 minus 0.75 exponential minus J omega. And from this, we can calculate amplitude and angle amplitude, all like this. Okay. Therefore, you can see this kind of one. This is the frequency response. Okay. Then the frequency means like this one. This one of the high pass filter. Okay. Then how do we know this kind of one? Then that you can solve the source problem here. I attach it. Okay, then therefore we need G transform, and from the we can estimate frequency response of roughly. Now generally, frequency response means some peaks and some valleys like this. Okay, for example, This is one of the low pass filter here. Then you can see this is here is a peak. This is a valley. And this is one of the high pass filter. In this case, here is a peak. This is a valley. And this is a band pass filter. Then this here is a peak. This is a valley is here. Okay. Therefore, what we can see, know from this is frequency response is, has some peaks and the valleys. Therefore, peak means in case of function, this we call it the pulse, and the valley means zeros of functions. For example, this kind of a function here, from this we can calculate pulse. Pulse means from this. And also zeros here. We know the from this we can know the poles. From this we can know the zeros. If we know poles and zeros, we can know the peaks and the valleys of a frequency response. Okay. Therefore, for this, for obtaining this low frequency response from the transfer function. We can know this. We can find the poles and the zeros. We can know the low shape of the frequency response. That's why we need G-transform. Okay, now here, let me compare the G-transform and Laplace transform here. Okay, now, G-transform is for the discrete time signal x of n. And x of s, Laplace transform is for the continuous time signal x of t. Okay? Therefore, this is the digital, for the digital signal, this is for the analogous signals. Okay? Then parameter, g. Okay, g equal r into exponential j omega. Here, the s means sigma plus j omega. Okay? Omega, of course, omega means 2pi normalized, normalized frequency and the omega equal to pi like this. And the point of g, in case of x of g, all points are on the circle whose radius is equal to r. This is the one of the r, okay? This is the some r function. All this is here. And in this case, this is some in the plane. The plane, okay. Then the in case of x of g, all point on the circle. In case of Laplace transform x of s is all point out in plane like this. Transform is this one. X of g equal x of n into g to the power minus one, and x of t into exponential minus f t dt. Okay. Here, most important thing is. For attenuating the amplitude of signals, okay, this is very important concept here, important one. This means now here r to the power minus n, r to the exponential minus of sigma t. Now here we define the g equal like this, g equal this one, then the this term means here this one, okay, this here. This is original signal, okay? This is original signal, and this is attenuation factor. This is attenuation factor. Attenuation factor. Okay? Also, this signal attenuation factor, same one. This is also attenuation factor. Okay? Because of this, xt, always xt goes to finite value. Okay. It is a very important concept, this one, attenuation factor is there. And here, frequency component, this is a frequency component. And this is also frequency component. And also, convergence means always convergence in ROC. This was always convergence in ROC because of this one. Okay, this is very important concept, okay? Also, because of this, the x of g and x of s is goes to finite value, not to go to infinite, okay? This. For this, we need some condition. We call this reasonable convergence. Okay, this is the MATLAB source code for your reference. Please try. Today, thank you so much for your watching. Today, I explained why G transform is needed. This is from the viewpoint of impulse response system and the frequency response and some equations in document and how to estimate the frequency response from the H over G like that. And also, I compared G transform and Laplace transforms. Next topic is G transform, and let me explain regional convergence and some practice for delta of n, unit function, and the exponentials. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.